Hello and welcome to Azure Wala YouTube channel. We are in part 26 of Microsoft Certified Associate series. So far we have completed 54 questions in previous videos. Today we are going to look into question number 55. So let's go. You have an Azure subscription that is used by 4 departments in your company. The subscription contains 10 resource groups. Each department uses resources in several resource groups. You need to send a report to finance department. The report must detail the cost for each department. Which 3 actions should you perform in sequence to answer move the appropriate action from the list of actions to the answer area and arrange them in the correct order. To create a detailed cost report for the department, we have to pick 3 actions. To pick the 3 actions, before that we need to understand the concept of tagging. So let's move to definition. So tags can be applied to any resource or resource group to segregate it or to filter it in cost report. So let's see what are the constraints of these tags. So tags must be applied directly to resource, aren't implicitly inherited from the parent resource group. So when we apply the tag on resource, it will be included, but if we include or apply the tag to resource group, it's not going to inherited and apply on the resource. So that's not, it doesn't work in that way. So we always have to be careful when we apply the tag for any department or any resource to segregate. We should apply the tag on the resource itself rather than applying on the resource group. So point number one, I hope it's clear. Resource tags are only supported for resource deployed in the resource group. So whenever we do have resources deployed in resource group, resource tags are going to be supported there only. A third point is some deployed resources may not support tags. So it depending on the resource type, they may not support the tags or may not include tags in usage data. So that's one possibility here. Resource tags are only included in usage data. So we have to be careful that this is going to be used in usage data only while tag is applied. And further, tags aren't applied to historical data. So we cannot use any historical data and apply the tags on them. So it should be, you know, active data in other sense. The next one is the resource tags are only available in cost management after the data is refreshed. So once the data is refreshed, tag is applied and data is refreshed, it will be available in cost management. It's not going to be available immediately. It may take 8 to 24 hours. So resource tags are only available in cost management when resource is active and running. That's another condition. If something is turned off, any virtual machine for example, it's not going to have that tag reflected. So and producing uses records. If any resource where the tag is applied is not producing any uses record, then it's not going to be visible in cost management. So like for example, if virtual machine is deallocated, it's not going to produce any uses record and it's not going to reflect the, in the cost management. Next one is managing tags require contributor access. So that's the permission we need to manage the tag. And managing tag policies require either owner or policy contributor access. So these are about the access information. To further strengthening our understanding on these, I have created 2 resource group. And let's say for example, in resource group we have 1 resource, which is 1 virtual network. So you can see resource group have a tag and we can apply certain tag on resource group. And then if we go to the resource group inside, if we do have For example, in resource group we have VNet1, the resource itself. It may have a different tag as well. So tags are not, for example, it is a department is equal to sales is applied here, and there was the department is equal to IT. So it may happen. And when we create a cost analysis report, we can view it like this. I will show. So we'll go to cost analysis on the subscription level. And here we can filter the tag, so tag will be reflecting while that resource is running. So here we can see the department tag label is there, and the department name will appear, which is the value like IT, sales, etc. Since we have recently applied the tags which I have showed you, so these are not reflecting here, but yes, after maybe 8 to 24 hours it's going to reflect in this report. And based on this filter, for example, we can filter out the report and have the report in place. So we understood how to use tags as filter here. And next one is downloading the report. So that is also possible. We can simply go to download here in cost management plus billing, and we can press the download and it start downloading the usage detail. So let's go to our answer area. Now let's see what are the sequence we can make here, the correct order of this. So first of all, we have to assign a tag to each resource, not the resource group. So we have to be careful, because once we assign the tag on the resource, we can filter it. If we assign tag on resource group, it's not going to inherit. Therefore, it's important to assign the tag on the resource itself. Second one is download is the last one. So the next one is from the cost analysis blade, filter the view. So that's what we have seen in Azure portal, that we can apply the filter on cost analysis blade, and we applied the filter and have understood that how we can see the result. So that's the next step. So step number one is this first one, assign the tag to each resource. Step number two is from the cost analysis blade, filter the view by tag. And step number three is that we can download the report or usage report from cost management plus billing part. So that is the step number three. So sequence would be that the first it would come, and the second, and then third it would come. I hope this video was informative for you, and if you like the video, please hit the like button. Also please subscribe and press the bell notification icon. Share with your friends and keep watching. See you in next video. Thank you.